Hey, everyone. This is Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode. And this is about the October update for the Xandeum blockchain. So for those of you who don't know, Xandeum is an innovative blockchain that adds a scalable storage layer to smart contracts, is using the Solana code base. If you want to know more, check out the links in the description. With our Xandeum project, the update for this month is, you know, the past 30 days have been really, really extraordinary. We have implemented vesting. We have finalized all the node store development. So we left node store behind us and can now fully focus with our dev team on the new blockchain. And we have our devnet up and running. It was a great, great success. We have almost 50 nodes. Probably over 50 nodes with what we have in the pipeline right now in our devnet. That is kind of remarkable. And, you know, the kind of enthusiasm that we have from so many of our community members, you know, not only to have these node licenses and earn the rewards, but also actually do the physical work and run their validators. It's just fantastic. Brad has done an awesome job in managing all this DevNet here. We now even have the second cluster up with our own validator software. And I traveled to India personally to work with the dev team and get the design up and running for the new validator software with the storage providers that we are developing. So if you like content like this, please give me that thumbs up. It's so important for the YouTube algorithm. I thank you in advance. And please leave me some comments. I mean, this is all exciting stuff, what we've done in the past 30 days. And leave me your comment about it. You know, tell me where I haven't been explicit enough and it needs more explanation. Tell me what you like and also tell me what you don't like. But yay, please leave me those comments there. They are super important to get the world up to date. I mean, you have the same questions as others. And, you know, we can just discuss these things in public and let the world know. All right, with the travel to India, which was just awesome, have all the development team and the design team there. And we were there for one full week designing the whole system with the storage provider nodes. And, you know, Felix got on board, our head of marketing, and we discussed with him all the different possibilities on how we can grow our community and not build only a community of the validators, but also a community of the storage nodes. So that's now absolutely the next thing that we have on mind. Our DevNet is now just for validating transactions, but the DevNet will have the storage provider functionality, and we will be adding that storage provider functionality into the validator code step by step and release by release. But we need lots and lots of, you know, volunteers that operate storage provider nodes even in our DevNet. And the storage provider will be completely permissionless in the future, so anyone can run a storage provider node. But for the DevNet, it might be a closed user group, and we're still thinking about how it all works. But that is super, super exciting. We will be adding the real eggs layer, the external global grouped storage that we're working on. We will draw the architecture, how it all works, how it you know, links into the source code of Solana and what it all means. And we will develop a demo app, right? And we don't know yet exactly what the demo app is, but there will be one app, a storage-enabled decentralized app, a so-called set app, as we call it. That's only possible on Xandeum, right? And we will have a demo app, and that might be, we're not sure yet, right? But it might be a really decentralized version of Wikipedia. Because everyone thinks Wikipedia is decentralized, and it is in a way, right? The work is being done in a decentralized fashion. So everyone writing articles for Wikipedia, they are all over the world, right? So they are really decentralized, but it all goes into one central database that's being controlled by one company, Wikipedia, and there's Jimmy Wales, and he can do anything, right? So there's no censorship resistance there, right? If Jimmy Wales would think that someone made a change and he doesn't like it, he can erase that change right out of the history, right? And all the others would not even see that there was a change made, right? So Wikipedia is, you know, centralized at its core. It has centralized control. Jimmy Wales, you can like it or not, but he's being scrutinized in the press the past few years because he has all these calls for donations there. And I donated like 2 years ago, and I thought, like, it all goes into the development of Wikipedia, right? It turns out it doesn't, right? He doesn't need all that money to keep Wikipedia up, right? There's not much development going on there. The software is kind of done. There's a few servers, of course, that needs to be operated. It costs a lot of money. I get that. But he's collecting way, way more Wikipedia donations. And then what does Jimmy Wales do? He's donating it to other organizations whose causes might be aligning with your causes as you donate it to Wikipedia, but it might not align, right? And in many cases, it won't align. So that's why I personally stopped donating to Wikipedia, but, you know, everyone makes their own choices there. But the thing is, Wikipedia is centralized and many people don't know it. They think like it's decentralized because anyone can make edits, right? Yeah, but Jimmy Wales can censor any edit, right? And he's the only one that can put the ads on there, right? And collect my, and all these type of things. So with Xandeum, right, it's like the Wikipedia database without images, without pictures. It's 200 gigabytes, right? 200 gigabytes. Storing that on Ethereum literally costs billions of dollars, right? And it still costs tens of millions, hundreds of millions on Solana to store 200 gigabytes. So we think we can do a Xandipedia as a demo app for Xandeum, right? And there, everything's stored there right on our storage layer, right? And it cannot be tampered with. It cannot be centrally controlled. And, you know, it's a real, real community owned by a DAO. Everyone who writes articles gets rewarded in those tokens. And the DAO votes on, you know, content moderation policies and all these type of things, right? So that would be a real Web3 app, right? Which cannot be built today. And I feel if we had the technology that Xandeum is building, someone would have done it, right? But they haven't, just because the technology isn't there, right? And in order to demonstrate what we can do with Xandeum, we aim to do this sort of demo app, put it out there in the world. It could be many, many other demo apps. You know, I've been talking about a Web3 Airbnb all the times. But I think with Wikipedia, it really illustrates the point. And also, we can populate Wikipedia, Xandipedia, with the Wikipedia database from day one because it's all CC BY, so all the copyright on the actual Wikipedia articles is all free. We can copy them, put them into Xandipedia, right? And then after that, we have the same data set in both, and then people can make their choice. If they make edits to a Wikipedia article, do they do it on Wikipedia where they grant basically their work to a centralized instance, Jimmy Wales, or do they do the same edit on Xandipedia where their edit is owned by the community and it is tamper-proof and it is censorship-resistant and they get rewarded in tokens? So I think probably that would be the better Wikipedia, right? And that is just one example. It's just one small example of what we can do with Xandeum, right? And we want to build one of these demo apps together with, you know, building the actual blockchain with the X layer, of course. And we want to do that together and show that demo app. Yeah, and man, that is now, I've been talking a long time, but, you know, the last month was really, really crazy. We've achieved so many things. We've let the node store development behind us. We've implemented vesting there, which means the team members that had their nodes granted in the early days, They are subject to vesting now. It was a major initiative to get that done. And, you know, doing all the changes that we needed to fix the bugs and to get the DevNet started and stuff like that, it's all set and done. So the whole development team can now refocus on the actual blockchain, on creating that validator, on creating the software that monitors the storage providers, sends them challenges, you know, picks the storage providers. And if they don't respond to the challenge as they should, then, you know, that storage node provider will just get fired and the validator software will find a new one to replace them. And all these types of things. So we've discussed all this architecture in India. It was an awesome team and an awesome travel and journey and with great results. And you will see that in the next few weeks and months. Also in the white paper, there will be lots of updates there. And we will be building the community of storage providers and yeah, we're going to be building that demo app and, you know, all these exciting things. So it was one of the most successful months that we had with so many things that we got accomplished with the DevNet and everything. So yeah, and it's all only possible because of you, because, you know, you guys are watching these videos. You're interested in what we're building here. You might even be part of our Discord community. If not, go to Xandeum.com and on the top right corner of our website, there's the Discord icon. Join our Discord community, super important. And some of you that are watching today are even part of the DevNet themselves. They're running nodes on our DevNet. So that's all just awesome, and I'm so excited for the future, and thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to give us that like button and subscribe to my channel to keep updated and stay updated on anything that happens regarding the Xandeum chain. So thanks so much, and catch you guys later.